HIV symptoms after 3 months. Hello, Mark Medicals here, teaching about HIV infection, like HIV treatment, HIV testing, and HIV transmission. In this video, we shall look at the following. 1. HIV/AIDS symptoms. 2. How long does it take for HIV symptoms to show? 3. HIV symptoms after 3 months. All right, here we go. 1. HIV/AIDS symptoms. I know this is confusing, but sincerely speaking, HIV has no specific symptoms. Early HIV symptoms, also known as acute HIV, include headache, sore throat, running nose, fever, body rash, enlarged lymph nodes, body weakness, and others. Those early symptoms are not due to HIV, but are a result of your body reacting to the new illness. So we have nothing like HIV-causing symptoms. As your body adjusts to the HIV, those symptoms will be a result. On the other hand, AIDS is nothing but a group of symptoms and signs, also called a syndrome. AIDS is the final stage of HIV infection and is characterized by persistent fever, severe body weight loss, chronic and persistent diarrhea, recurrent chest infections like TB, chronic fatigue, mental illness, and others. 2. How long does it take for HIV symptoms to show? Usually, after exposure to HIV infection, your body begins reacting to the new virus after 2 to 4 weeks, and symptoms already mentioned earlier will show up. Only 65% of people will see symptoms, and these symptoms last for 2 to 4 weeks. Some studies report that, in very few people, those symptoms could last for up to 3 months. 3. HIV symptoms after 3 months. Only 65% of people are likely to get early HIV symptoms, meaning that many people usually see no symptoms yet their virus continues multiplying in their bodies. Studies have shown that very few people experience symptoms up to 3 months, but a greater percentage will only feel unwell for 2 to 4 weeks. So, HIV symptoms after 3 months are most likely extended acute HIV symptoms, or another illness other than HIV. Studies have shown that, after acute HIV, the person will likely experience no HIV-related symptoms or signs till late stage in about 10 years when the body immunity is severely weakened. Having said that HIV has no specific symptoms, therefore, using symptoms to diagnose HIV is wrong. The only way to know if you have HIV is by having an HIV testing. Some people have HIV phobia and anxiety, a reason they continue experiencing false symptoms. If you have false symptoms, see a psychologist. We recommend you have at least 2 HIV tests, 2 months apart for early HIV diagnosis, HIV treatment, and prevent HIV transmission to your loved ones.